Laredo Pride's mission is to empower people to reach their potential by creating a safe and caring community where diversity is celebrated and all people are respected, valued, and affirmed by inclusive of their sexual orientation, gender identity, gender expression, or HIV status. Welcome everyone. My name is Eduardo Elizalvo, and I am the founder and president of Laredo Pride. And it's such a great honor to welcome you to our first variety show. This show is created for everyone who wants to show off their talent or express themselves. If you have any type of talent, from crafting to singing or anything in between, and want to be part of this show, please send us an email at laredopride1@gmail.com, and we will let you know the requirements. Bienvenidos todos. Mi nombre es Eduardo Erilizardo. Y soy el fundador y presidente de la Laredo Pride. Es un gran honor darles la bienvenida a nuestro primer show de variedad. Este espectáculo es creado para todos que quieren demostrar su talento o se quieren expresar. Si usted tiene cualquier tipo de talento, desde elaboración hasta el canto o cualquier cosa en el medio, por favor envíenos un correo electrónico a laredopride1@gmail.com. Y le haremos saber los requisitos. Today's segment consists of topics such as cooking with Laredo Pride, where we will show you how to cook an authentic Mexican dish, which is called pinga. We will demonstrate how to paint a beautiful rainbow landscape, and we'll have an interview with one of our local pianists, and we will have entertainment as well. Nuestro siguiente de hoy consiste en temas como cocinar con Laredo Pride, donde le mostraremos cómo cocinar un auténtico platillo mexicano que se llama pinga. Vamos a demostrar cómo pintar un hermoso paisaje con colores de arcoíris. Y vamos a tener una entrevista con uno de nuestros pianistas locales y vamos a tener entrenamiento.
Hola, mi nombre es Margarita Marfil Mora. Soy fundadora de la organización Laredo Pride. Laredo Pride es una estructura sin fines de lucro al servicio de la comunidad LGBTQ y más. Nuestra asociación fue fundada el 30 de mayo de 2017. La misión de Laredo Pride es empoderar a las personas para que alcancen su máximo potencial mediante la creación de una comunidad segura y solidaria, donde se celebra la diversidad y donde todas las personas son respetadas, valoradas y afirmadas, incluyendo su orientación sexual, identidad de género, expresión de género o estado del VIH. Te invito a ser parte de nuestra organización, en la cual recibirás el apoyo y atención. Visítanos en nuestras redes sociales, por Facebook, Instagram y en nuestra página que es www.laredopride.org. Gracias. Somos los fundadores de la organización de Laredo Pride, de la comunidad. Esta noche vamos a cocinar en cuarentena. ¿Qué vamos a preparar esta noche? Vamos a preparar un platillo exquisito, típicamente mexicano, el cual lleva pechuga ya desmenuzado, 2 tazas de agua del caldo de pollo de la pechuga, una cebolla entera fileteada, 120 gramos de chile chipotle, 4 tomates hervidos, 1 cucharada de aceite, sal y pimienta.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hello, how are you doing? We're the founders of Laredo Pride, and today we're going to cook an authentic Mexican dish, which is tinga. You're going to use the ingredients are chicken, the chicken broth, 1 onion, 120 chipotle sauce, 4 tomatoes, salt, and pepper, which are optional. And also we're gonna use oil.
Muy bien. Para empezar, tenemos que preparar el primero ingrediente que viene siendo los chiles con el tomate, con la sal y con una cucharada de, una tacita de agua. Son los chiles chipotles. Que huelen muy rico. Los cuatro tomates hervidos que ya sirvieron con anterioridad. Y vamos a agregar la tacita de caldo que nos va a permitir que el chile se mezcle bien con el tomate. Vamos a colar el refrigerador y el refractario. Vamos a colar el chile.
What we're doing right now, we're just trying to separate the seeds from the rest of the chipotle sauce. We just want the sauce itself, no seeds, no anything like that.
Como pueden ver, es una receta fácil y muy rica. Ahorita el que está grabando el video nos va a dar el punto de calidad, si quedó bueno. Él es especialista en tingas. Se recomienda utilizar un colador fino para que no dejar que se vaya ningún pellejito del chile chipotle, ningún pellejito del tomate. Ya se me está haciendo agua la boca. Laredo Pride es una organización que está pugnando por los derechos que tienen las personas que pertenecen a la comunidad, porque sean respetados, porque todos somos seres humanos. Este material de aquí ya no sirve, como ven, es puro bagazo.
As you can see, this is the way it's supposed to look.
Muy bien, ahora vamos a pasar a cocinar. El aderezo. Muy bien. Para eso necesitamos la cucharada de aceite. Pueden ver, es nomás una cucharada, porque esta nos va a permitir así tronar la cebolla, la cual tenemos que así tronar de 3 a 5 minutos para que quede transparente. Como se le llama aquí, nosotros le llamamos la cebolla de papel, porque cambia su textura, cambia su sabor, cambia su olor. Como pueden ver, una cucharada es suficiente. ¿Para qué? Para que toda persona pueda consumirla. Y son recetas sencillas que quedan con muy buen sabor. Ya se desprende el aroma de la cebolla. Mucha gente dice que es para citronar la cebolla. Se le llama de diferente manera. Aquí la misma cebolla nos va diciendo el momento de que ya está quedando lista. No se nos debe de quemar, ¿eh? Ahora, en caso de que se nos queme la cebolla, pues la podemos vaciar en un platito, le ponemos limón y ya nos la comemos con otra comida, con unos taquitos. Esta cebolla ya está lista, como pueden ver, ya está lista la cebolla para que suelte su juguito. ¿Qué vamos a hacer ahora? Vamos a echar el caldito del chile chipotle.
No, ya se me va a pasar. Cuando haces ese para que nos mire los dos.
Bueno, le bajo. Permitimos que el chile chipotle agarre el sabor de la cebolla. Y ahora vamos a agregar el ingrediente principal, que viene siendo el pollo. Aquí el pollo se mezcla junto con la cebolla y pierde la cebolla el olor, el color del ingrediente que dice uno, ay no, a mí no me gusta la cebolla. La cebolla está ya está sofreída. Y si queremos que nuestra tinga quede más jugosita, podemos ponerle caldito de pollo. O si la queremos seca, se puede quedar así. Vamos a agregarle un caldito de pollo, poquito. Poquito caldito de pollo. Para que empiece a hervir. Pueden agregarle una hojita de laurel, unas dos hojitas de laurel, pero como ahorita estamos en la de quédate en casa, unas hojitas de laurel no nos iban a detener para hacer este plato. Es opcional agregarle pimienta y agregarle sal. Las personas que padecen de hipertensión no necesitan agregarle sal porque el chile chipotle ya lo tiene. Ya tenemos nuestra tinga. Hay varias formas de presentarla, ahorita la vamos a presentar.
Ya después de que está la tinga, este ahora tiempo de disfrutarla. Está cruda en salida, está calientita. So, vamos a preparar dos maneras, una sin, una con aguacate y una con crema. Las dos saben bien ricas las dos maneras. So, ya se está sirviendo de una, ya, mientras.
El aguacate recomiendo cortarlo en cuadritos. Ya lo saca uno y lo sirve. ¿Se sirve? Y aquel que ya está servido, nomás se le agrega
la crema. La crema es para que se le quita un poco lo picoso si le sale picoso. Y la agua.
Aquí está.
Y ahora lo único que nos falta es la prueba de cómo nos salió. Bien rica, está calentita, pero bien rica.
Esperemos que esta receta la lleven a cabo en casa para que vean ustedes que es bien fácil. Es algo que puede uno hacer y no se tarda uno mucho, se tarda uno más en coger la pechuga de pollo, y si no podemos tener la pechuga de pollo, puede ser también con pierna de pollo, nada más que le da otra textura, ¿verdad? Y que disfruten esta receta de tinga, y fue un orgullo y un gusto estar con ustedes. Somos de la organización
de la Aero Pride. Esperemos que se estén cuidando durante estos momentos. Si van a salir, como siempre están anunciando en la televisión y en todos los medios, por favor, cúbrense la boca, la nariz, estén a salvo, mantener su distancia. Si no son de la misma familia o de la misma casa, por favor, mantener su distancia. Que son 6 pies. ¿Cuántos metros vienen a ser?
1.5.
Por favor, es muy importante de que se cuiden uno al otro, porque los queremos ver al final de todo esto, allá afuera, celebrando juntos, que ya suframos todo lo que este año nos está dando. Gracias a todos. Yo soy Eri Lizardo, uno de los fundadores de la Aero Pride. Y ella es
Margarita Marfil Mora, también fundadora de la Aero Pride.
Gracias y cuídense. Nos vemos después. Wasn't that recipe appetizing? ¿No les gustó mucho esta receta? Porque a mí sí, me encantó. No pude acabar para poder comerme todo la tinga, pero tuve que disfrutarlo. I couldn't wait to finish cooking so I could eat all the tinga, but I had to share. Our next segment is a small entertainment by one of our queens, Miss Jackie Lantern. Nuestro siguiente segmento es un show pequeño por una de nuestras reinas, Miss Laredo Pride 2020, Miss Jackie Lantern.
Hi, my name is Jackie Lantern from Laredo, Texas, and I'm your Miss Laredo Pride 2020 along with Sassy Real Phillips. And I would like to encourage everybody to participate in social distancing wherever you go, whether it's an essential workplace or just going outside. Please wear a mask wherever you go and do not touch your eyes, your mouth, your nose, nothing that will lead to something going into your body and getting you sick. Please stay safe, and we're going to have a lot of events coming up, hopefully. In order for that to happen, you need to stay home. Make sure to sanitize your hands and have a great night, everybody. And peace.
Sleepless alert tonight. If it's wrong to love you, then my heart just won't let me be right. 'Cause I'm drowned in you, and I won't pull through without you by my side. I'd give my all to have just one more night. Your body next to me. in my mind, and yet you're so far, like a distant star I'm wishing on tonight. I give my all to hell, just one more night with you. I'd risk my love to be around your body next to mine, 'cause I can't go on living in the memory of our song. I give my all for your love tonight.
Hola, soy Elizabeth Cancino, tesorera de Laredo Pride. Estoy muy orgullosa de pertenecer a esta organización porque soy del pensar que todos merecemos respeto.
Thank you, Jackie. Gracias, Jackie. I hope you enjoy her show. Espero que les haya gustado este show. Vamos a continuar con este programa. Let's continue with our program. Now we have Ms. Jasmine Cantu, one of our local artists. Ahora sigue Ms. Jasmine Cantu, una de nuestras artistas pintoras locales. Les va a enseñar cómo hacer un paisaje usando los colores de arcoíris. She will show us how to build a beautiful landscape using rainbow colors.
Hey, what's up, guys? My name's Jasmine here from at Art of Joy Jasmine, and I'm here to bring you a wonderful Pride rainbow-themed painting today. Here's all the things that you'll need. You may want to pause the video to make sure you grab all that info. And you can do this on any size canvas. You could literally do it on a square, rectangle, whatever you'd like. It'll still get you the same result. And I'm starting with my red. My red is gonna go pretty much about a quarter down the screen, or down the canvas, I mean. And I'm just going through every single color. So you'll see me go through yellow in just a moment as well. So actually, you're going to see me use orange first, and again, I'm just going down the line, also trying to create a gradation, and you'll see me kind of pick up my brush and move it up towards the red as well. And now with the yellow, the same thing. I kind of lay down a layer of color right under the orange, and then I pick my brush up into that orange. You'll see some of that orange, of course, move into the yellow. Which I do think still makes it look quite wonderful anyway. A little more realistic, perhaps. So you'll see that happen. I even add a little bit of red at the bottom as well, but you won't really get to see that in the finished product, so you might want to either add more or do away with it if you don't want to have that little red gradation in there. You could also keep your mountains a little bit lower on your canvas, and that'll also let that red peek out. So now that I've finished the background and of course let it dry up, I'm gonna go in with a green paint. I did go ahead and add a little bit of blue and white to this green, so it's kind of like a, I wanna say like a eucalyptus leaf kind of green. So kind of like a green blue, but I just thought it would look better if I did this and also kind of go with the gradient look that I'm trying to get. And I'm just making some mountain peaks. I'm not super worried about like perfection per se, but I am also kind of paying attention to those details where the mountains are definitely pointing up. And they're not all just like, you know, little rectangles, like they have different size peaks. There's also like some lower areas, all that good stuff. Once I have that down, I'm gonna go in with a light blue, and I just used a little bit of white and blue to create that. And I'm essentially doing the same thing, just a little bit lower than the green. And again, I'm creating some peaks. I'm not going to try to match them. I want them to look different from the mountains atop. And I basically do this for dark blue and dark purple or violet as well. As I went through each color, I did allow some dry time, like 10-15 minutes, just because it makes it easier to apply color on top. So as you transition from the green, light blue, dark blue to the violet, you definitely want to wait for it to dry or you'll have a harder time covering some of those areas. I also went back a couple of times and touched up some areas that did dry. Like I could see some of my, like under the canvas on some of the green and stuff like that. So I just went in with my brush and made sure those areas were covered. And right now I'm adding like a sun and I'm using a really light yellow mixture. So I'm just using yellow and white, mostly white, to get that kind of sun color. And I just take my time when it comes to circles, making sure that they're nice and covered and that they're fairly accurate in shape as well. I went ahead and decided that I did want to add some dark purple at the very top. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm kind of like trying to add onto that gradation. So you'll see I'm going to add like some really nice dark purple. It's going to look kind of just like put there. So what I do is just grab a little more red and kind of try to fade that edge out so that it all kind of looks like it's fading into the next color. So now I'm going to go ahead and add some details. I'm going to use the back of my brush as like kind of like a dotting tool to make some stars. And I'm going to try to concentrate all those stars into that dark area. And they're going to get further and further apart as they go down the canvas. I'm not really even going to go all the way down the canvas. I'm just adding a couple of stars into the brighter areas of the sky to kind of, you know, give it like, a, again, kind of like a like if it's really dark out or it's about to get dark and some of those stars are kind of peeking out into the sunset. And here's a close-up of the painting that we've just done. And I really hope that you've enjoyed this little paint-along. Don't forget, you can always do this yourself. I know it seems intimidating, but as you can see, it's a really easy painting. I'm thinking about also having a step-by-step painting class of this particular painting as well. So please, if you happen to have time, go ahead and like and follow my page on Facebook and Instagram. You can find me at Art of Joy Jasmine or Art by Jasmine Cantu. And like I mentioned, I do painting classes. I do also sell personal work. I even take commissions for acrylic and watercolor paintings. So if you're in the market for one of those, please, please, please take a look when you have a chance. And hopefully we can work together or paint together. I'd really like to do that. Anyways, guys, again, my name's Jasmine, and thank you, Laredo Pride, for giving me this platform to show some of my techniques. And thank you for watching.
Hola, mi nombre es Di Alvarado. Orgullosamente soy miembro activo de la organización Laredo Pride. Recordemos que la homosexualidad no es una enfermedad, la homofobia sí.
Hello, my name is Jasmine Cantu, and I'm the secretary here for Laredo Pride. And I joined this organization to be a part of a wonderful group of people, all working towards building a community of tolerance and compassion for all.
What's up, guys? This is Luis talking here, or as I go by, Luigi Barra. I'm 23, from Laredo, Texas. I had attended Martin High, VMT for 1 year, my senior year, I believe. And, you know, so I attended VMT for choir, I was in Martin for band, so throughout all my high school years, I was pretty much involved with music a lot. I was introduced to piano, I'd say senior year, my second semester. I first started off with flute, funny, right? I actually started with flute back in band, started learning how to read music and how to play flute at the same time. Not the best, especially for the fact that I have friends that were, you know, they were already in band since middle school, they already knew how to like play and read music. I don't know what was going on my freshman year, I was just everywhere. I also recently been playing violin, and I also used to play drums. So I try to be an all-around musician, you know, but piano is just something that really got stuck in me. I've been playing piano for about 4, maybe 5 years max. So surprisingly, I've been very, 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 dedicated, I guess I can say dedicated, with piano, especially because piano is just basically an orchestra in one instrument, you know, you got bass, you got treble, you got tenor, you got alto, voices and piano already. Some good experiences I've had, I've played out of town. I actually first started playing out of town more than locally. I used to play at San Antonio, Austin. My debut actually started in Austin, surprisingly, at a bar and grill restaurant. They had open mic, or better yet, I was randomly playing at a park back in Austin. this lady heard me playing and she gave me her business card and told me to stop by Iron Cactus. I don't know if y'all ever heard of it. There's just at least two locations in Austin, and told me they're having an open mic. So I went, played about three songs, and that's how I started, basically. And you know, after that I had came back to Laredo. I haven't performed anywhere. I went on an out-of-town trip to Houston back when one of my closest friends, he had a orientation for UTI. Took him over there. Next thing you know, I started looking around piano places, and I found one in Galveston. So I asked my friends, hey, y'all want to go to Galveston? There's this bar that I want to check out, and whatever. So we went to the beach and everything, and we went to the bar, and that place, they were hearing how I played. They pretty much liked it, so I had every once a month I had a performance over there. So pretty good experience. I was the opening act for LGBT Pride events over there in Galveston, 2018 I believe, or 2019, 2018. In 2018, I was their opening event for LGBT Pride. I think that was one of the best amazing nights ever. It was really, really packed for a small bar. And then I started playing here more often for an open mic. And eventually it just led up to me having my own personal acoustic nights. And 2019, I was the ending act for one of the Pride events here for Frontera. I think that was pretty cool, you know. And so then last year again, I was one of the performances for LGBT at Frontera. I appreciate Frontera, especially being one of the best sponsorships I have around. Very, very amazing people. And how have things changed the pandemic? Oof. The pandemic really, really, really has taking its toll in everybody, but I still post videos here and there online. I started opening my YouTube more often, as well as I need to get back to my Facebook pages. I have a Facebook page dedicated for my piano stuff. I have an Instagram page dedicated for my piano stuff. I will eventually put it in on my description. A few hobbies I have. I actually do canvas painting. I've recently gotten back to it ever since the pandemic, or better yet, ever since we were all under quarantine. I started sketching again, I started doing canvases again. I even went back to my video games. I have not touched my consoles in like half a year, I could say. I've been having gigs here and there, up and down. I was at least in three bands. They would have one gig this week, I would have a gig with this other band next week, I would have another gig with another band. Sometimes even on the same weekend I'll have two gigs in one. But recently I've been having my hobbies where sometimes I just get on YouTube, just browse, you know, people who I usually get my motivations from other pianists. Or inspired by other pianists. What else? You can also find me on social media. You can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for the most part. I've been planning to have a Twitter lately, but for now it's just the three basic ones, which is Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. I will put it in the description down below so y'all can subscribe, follow, add. Facebook, I have personal Facebook and my Facebook page, my piano Facebook page. And that's about it. I will see y'all around, and maybe hopefully I get to have some new fans, new audiences, and new friends. And it's been a pleasure to be, you know, I'm getting out there, and I'll see y'all around.
Hello, this is Miss Cecilia Phillips, Miss Laredo Pride 2020. Just a friendly reminder to stay home, only go out for essentials, wash your hands often, practice social distancing, and always cover your mouth and nose when going outside and when entering a building. Remember, Laredo Pride loves you, I love you, and we hope to see you soon with good health. Goodbye.
Wasn't that marvelous? No era maravilloso. I like listening to piano. It was relaxing and soothing. Me gustó cómo se escuchó su piano. Era relajante y sudante. Y desafortunadamente, con eso vamos a cerrar este show. Unfortunately, with that, we will have to close our show. But before we take off, we do want to say that our next show will bring Miss Barbara Brooks, one of our local directors. Antes de terminar, quiero decir que para el próximo show que vamos a tener, vamos a traer a Miss Barbara Brooks, una de nuestras reinas de aquí, de Laredo y Nuevo Laredo.
Hola amigos, buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Barbara Brooks. Quiero darle el agradecimiento a la página de Laredo Pride por haberme dado la participación de mostrar un poquito de lo poquito que hacemos aquí dentro de la comunidad LGBT. Muchas gracias a todos los que nos apoyan. Les pido por favor que siempre sigan así, siempre dando una buena cara para las personas que lo necesitan. Gracias a todos, de verdad. Recuerden que la homosexualidad no es una enfermedad, pero la homofobia sí lo es. Muchas gracias amigos.
Por favor, visítenos, como les he dicho, a nuestras redes sociales, Facebook, Instagram y nuestra página. Please visit us, our social media, Facebook, Instagram, and our webpage. Remember, guys, please protect yourself, please love yourself, because Laredo Pride is here for you, and we care for you. And we do want to see you at the end of this pandemic. Recuerden todos, por favor, cuídense uno al otro. Ámense uno al otro, porque la Laredo Pride los quiere y queremos verlos al final de esta pandemia. Y hasta entonces los esperemos en el próximo show. Until then, we'll see you in the next show. Bye.